This is SEMA Central. I'm Kevin Oste at the 2017 SEMA Show here in Las Vegas. And I'm joined by Ian Len. And Ian is a really interesting kind of, almost kind of a case study for one of the interesting programs done here at SEMA. And you've been not only somebody who's entered the organization, but now you're getting involved with the emerging technology and trends network.
Yep.
And your own products. So we got a lot of stuff to talk about.
Absolutely. So no, it's a lot of acronyms with SEMA. So it's Emerging Trends and Technology Network, ETTN.
I had that backwards.
It's all good.
I do it every time.
Absolutely.
Tell me a little bit about your background, because it's been kind of a short time frame, but you've got a lot done.
Yeah. So my company was born out of a senior exit thesis while I was in college. And after that, my professor told me about SEMA. And basically the next day, I joined SEMA, joined Yen, entered into the Launchpad competition, which is SEMA's version of Shark Tank. And after winning that, my company kind of took off from there, and it's, you know, I haven't had a chance to look back since then, so it's been really exciting.
So we've been talking to some of the finalists and other current round, if you will, entrants in the SEMA Launchpad experience, but you've been through it, you won it, mm-hmm. So tell me what it's been like since you won that.
Yeah, so I think I remember sitting up on stage, you know, 3 years ago when I won the competition, and since then, I still feel ripples from when we won that. We went from a small company in southern Florida to now we're sold in 33 countries around the world, all 50 states, and I have SEMA and the Young Executive Network to really thank for that.
It's incredible.
And putting us on the map. I mean, SEMA is the authority in all things automotive aftermarket, and to win an award like that and putting the SEMA badge on your company feels really good, and it looks even better internationally.
I can only imagine, and it's fascinating to me to know that it's more than just the award, it's the networking and the other kind of tips that you picked up along the way, I think that might have been helpful.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, obviously the award, you know, the package that you get from winning Launchpad is fantastic, all the marketing and exposure, but I think the most value that I got from Launchpad was just the mentorship and the relationships that I got from the competition. It was incredible, and I still have all of those relationships today.
And what I think is also very cool is you're not the kind of guy who's going to take the money and run. I mean, you're now here in a committee capacity with SEMA, so you're giving back.
Yeah. So after winning Launchpad, I got onto the select committee for Yen. And since then, I've moved over to ETTN, the Emerging Trends and Technology Network. What I don't think a lot of people realize is that volunteering is, you end up getting more than you put into it. Mm. I know it might sound a little bit cheesy, but it's totally true. Anybody will tell you it's all about who you know. Mm-hmm. And you really get to meet everybody when you're volunteering. You get to rub elbows with the Ron Colemans and the Doug Evans, all these big names and these industry icons that, as a small guy coming out of college with a little company, I might not have been able to bump into, but now I get to have a beer with them at the banquet and chat about shop, so it's awesome.
Sure, so when you get these opportunities to have the exposure, what are some of the stuff that you gain from these?
Oh, I mean, all the different networks within SEMA offer tons of benefits, both to the membership, but also the volunteer. I mean, ETTN is, we're more focused towards the engineers and the technical professionals in our industry. But I mean, we're engaging the OEMs, we're engaging innovators, figuring out what's coming down the pipeline. This is information that's still 3, 4, 5 years out that we're getting to sit and learn about and present to our members, which it's fulfilling, but it also helps us position ourselves to take advantage of the opportunities coming down the pipeline for innovation.
And very quickly, tell me about the product that got you going.
Boostane is it's a fuel solution. We can transform your regular pump fuel from 93 octane all the way to 116 octane if you really need it. So we're more of a race fuel alternative than anything, but we're trying to give people, especially the grassroots movements, the drifters, the Gambler 500 guys, the guys that are racing on the weekends, the Weekend Warriors. We're trying to give them the opportunity to have that high-octane alternative without having to carry around 5 gallon pails of race fuel and being kind of chained to the drum, I guess is what we
would
say.
Right on. Yeah. Well, adding octane in a convenient manner is convenient.
That's right. No, and I mean, you know, that's kind of the way of the industry right now. Smaller CC engines and higher compression, forced induction. So octane's gonna be an issue, and we're hoping to help people with that.
Right on. Well, Ian, you're a great example of a guy who is, in my opinion, truly getting as much benefit out of being involved with SEMA as you can.
It's fantastic.
And it's great to see you being proactive and reaching out there and going for it, meeting people, making those connections. That's what this experience should be all about.
Absolutely.
And you're seeing the benefits, and it's great to see.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, Ian, we appreciate it.
Yeah.
A great success story from somebody who's becoming more and more involved with the SEMA organization here at the 2017 SEMA Show.
Thanks, Kevin.